好，我们一同为今天的信息来祷告。
Let's pray together for today's message.
亲爱的父神，我们感谢赞美你。
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you and praise you.
主啊，我们感谢主你拯救了我们。
Thank you for your salvation.
我们也感谢主你召聚我们来敬拜赞美你。
Thank you for gathering us together here today to worship you and praise you.
主啊，赐给我们一颗谦卑顺服的心。
Lord, please give us a submissive heart.
使我们听见主你的话语便存在心里，并且照着去做。
So we keep your words in our hearts and follow it.
主啊，愿你的子民们都能够荣耀你。
May all your people glorify you.
主啊，带领我们走这永生的道路。
And lead us to walk the way of to the eternal life.
保守我们今天的信息从开头直到末了。
And bless today's message from the beginning to the end.
与我们同在
and walk with us.
我们的感谢和祷告都是奉我主耶稣基督的圣名。
Our praises and prayer in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
好，我们先来读一下今天的经文。
Let's start from the verses.
今天的经文是马太福音第五章的38-42节。
It's Matthew chapter 5 verses 38 to 42.
我们先一起用中文来读，然后再用英文读。
We'll read together in Chinese first and then in English.
你们听见有话说，以眼还眼，以牙还牙。只是我告诉你们，不要与恶人作对。有人打你的右脸，连左脸也转过来由他打。有人想要告你，要拿你的里衣，连外衣也由他拿去。有人强逼你走一里路，你就同他走二里。有求你的就给他，有向你借贷的不可推辞。好，我们再用英文来读。
You have heard that it was said, eye for eye and tooth for tooth. But I say to you, do not show opposition against any evil person. But whoever slaps you on your right cheek,Turn the other toward him also. And if anyone wants to sue you and take your tunic, let him have your cloak also. Whoever forces you to go 1 mile, go with him too. Give to him who asks to you, and do not turn away from him who wants to borrow from you.
今天是透过圣经看政治的第21讲，标题是当尊神职，莫问前程。
Today is the 21st sermon of the theories of biblical politics through a biblical view. The topic today is obey God's will, worry not the future.
这个是王明道弟兄说的话，意思是基督徒做事，我们只要看是否是神的旨意，是神的旨意呢，就勇敢的去行，不用管前面的道路如何。
The title is a quote from Brother Baoming Dao. It means that when Christians do things, it's the God's will that should be his only concern. If it is God's will, then do it bravely, regardless of what the passes look like.
就像亚伯拉罕被呼召出乌尔的时候呢，他都不知道应该去哪里。
Just like when Abraham was called out of Ur, he doesn't know where to go.
但他知道呢，离开这个城市就对了。
But he knows he needs to leave the city.
前面的道路呢，神会带领他。
And the rest will be led by God.
这个呢，应该成为所有基督徒的座右铭。
This should be the motto of every Christian.
但是呢，现实情况却并非如此。
But the reality is often not the case.
许多基督徒并没有这样的心智。
Many Christians doesn't have this heart.
而这一段经文呢，是圣经中最多被误解的经文。
And the verses we just read is also one of the most misunderstood passages in the Bible.
因此，我想借着这段经文呢，来解释遵行神的旨意这个主题。
So I want to use this passage and explain what it means to obey God's will.
这段经文呢是主耶稣登山宝训中的一段。
The verse is part of the Sermon on the Mountain.
在登山宝训中，主耶稣频繁的使用“你们听见有话说，但是我告诉你们”这样的句式。
In the Sermon on the Mountain, Lord Jesus often used a pattern that you often hear, but I say to you.
这里的“你们听见有话说”指的是当时犹太拉比们的教导。
In this pattern, you often hear refers to the teachings from the rabbis.
而我告诉你们，则是主耶稣对这些错误观念的纠正。
And but I say to you is Lord Jesus correcting this misunderstanding.
主耶稣纠正了当时的以色列百姓对旧约的错误的理解。
Lord Jesus was correcting the misunderstanding of the Israelites to the Old Testament.
而在今天呢，主耶稣说的这些话呢，又再次被错误的理解和教导。
But today, these words spoken by Lord Jesus is yet once again misunderstood and mistaught.
这些错误的教导呢，使得教会里面出现了一大堆软绵绵的基督徒。
These wrong ideas causes a lot of weak and soft Christians in the church.
他们面对邪恶的时候呢，闷不吭声，一味的退让。
Who just blindly give in when they are facing evil.
他们懦弱无力，还以为自己是在践行主的教导。
They are weak, yet they thought they were practicing the teaching of Christ.
但是呢，我们请看看主耶稣的榜样。
But look at Lord Jesus' example.
他看见人在圣殿中做买卖的时候呢，他就大发易怒，如同烈火。
When he saw people doing business in the temple, he was outraged with righteousness.
为着神的公义呢，他敢当众掀翻这些人做买卖的桌子。
For the sake of God's righteousness, he flipped the table of those who are doing business.
他敢冒犯这些权贵的核心利益。
He offended the core interests of those powerful people.
约翰福音三章第八节说，神的儿子显现出来，为要除灭魔鬼的作为。
John 3:8 says, "For this purpose the Son of God appeared, that he might destroy the works of the devil."
主耶稣岂是向这个魔鬼退让的人呢
？Lord Jesus wouldn't give in to the devil.
基督徒作为主的门徒，也是注定要跟魔鬼征战。
And Christians, as the followers of the Lord, will be fighting with the devil as well.
而对于这段经文的错误解释呢，就好像打断了基督徒的脊梁骨一样的，使他们一面对邪恶势力就当了逃兵。
The wrong interpretation of the passage is like breaking the backbone of a Christian, causing them to retreat whenever they face any evil forces.
因而呢，正确的解释这段经文呢，对于教会而言意义重大。
That's why it's very important and meaningful for the church to correctly understand this passage.
于是呢，我们必须要回到主耶稣说这个话的语境，我们才能够真正明白他的意思。
And we need to get back to the context when Lord Jesus spoke these teachings to understand the true meaning of it.
以眼还眼，以牙还牙，这句话呢，连外邦人都耳熟能详。
Eye for an eye and tooth for a tooth is something that even the Gentiles are familiar with.
人们呢，把它作为个人报复的合理依据。
The verse is often used as a justification for revenge.
拉比正是如此教导。
And this is exactly how the rabbis taught it.
他们说呢，如果有人伤害了你呢，你有权利去报复，以牙还牙，以眼还眼。
They tell you that if somebody harm you, you have the right to revenge, an eye for an eye and tooth for a tooth.
但是呢，让我们回到以牙还牙的最早出处去寻找它原本的意思。
But today, let's go back to where the phrase tooth for a tooth originally come from to find the true meaning of the phrases.
我们看出埃及记的二十一章的二十二到二十五节。
Look at Exodus chapter 21 verses 22 to 25.
人若彼此争斗，伤害有孕的妇人，甚至堕胎，随后却无别害，那伤害他的总要按妇人的丈夫所要的，照审判官所断的受罚。若有别害，就要以命偿命，以眼还眼，以牙还牙，以手还手，以脚还脚，以绕还绕。以伤还伤，以打还打。
The verse says, "Now if people struggle with each other and strike a pregnant woman so that she gives birth prematurely, but there is no injury, the guilty person shall certainly be fined as the woman's husband may demand of him, and he shall pay as the judges decide. But if there is any further injury, then you shall appoint as a penalty life for life, eye for eye, tooth for tooth, hand for hand, foot for foot.Burn for burn, wound for wound, and bruise for bruise.
好，我们再看另外一处经文，《生命记》的十九章二十到二十一节。
Next verse is in Deuteronomy chapter 19, verses 20 to 21.
别人听见都要害怕，就不敢在你们中间再行这样的恶了。你们眼不可顾惜，要以命偿命，以眼还眼，以牙还牙，以手还手，以脚还脚。
And the rest of people will hear and be afraid and will never again do such an evil thing among you. So you shall not show pity, life for life, eye for eye, tooth for tooth, hand for hand, and foot for foot.
所以你看见了吗？以牙还牙，它不是发生在私人报复当中。
The important thing you want to notice is tooth for tooth does not happen in a personal revenge.
它发生在审判官的审判。
It happened during a trial of a judge.
这个是第一点。
This is the first point.
第二点呢，这个刑罚呢，必须和被告所犯的罪行要对等，而不是超过。
The second point is that the penalty must be equal to the crime committed by the defendant, not more than.
这样呢，就彰显了神的公义。
This is a manifestation of God's righteousness.
当神的公义彰显的时候呢，他就既刑罚了过去犯下的罪恶，也遏制了将来罪恶的蔓延。
And God's righteousness will punish the crime that were committed and will also prevent the spread of the crime in the future.
但犹太拉比以这些经文为根据呢，鼓励人有报私仇的权利，这个是完全的错解经文。
But the rabbis encourage people to do personal revenge and use these verses as the foundation. This is a completely misunderstanding of the passage.
人的本性是自私的。
Humans are born selfish.
都会强调呢，我有什么权利
？Want to emphasize what right do I have？
而不是在神眼中什么是好的
？Not what is pleasing to God。
因而呢，这些拉比的这些观点呢，是讨人喜欢的。
You can see these teachings of the rabbis are pleasing to people。
而属神的人的特点恰恰相反。
But the godly person is the opposite。
他们为了神国的利益呢，他们能够放下自己的利益。
Those are the people who are able to give up his own interests for the benefits of the kingdom of God.
比如说主耶稣的榜样。
For example, our Lord Jesus has a good example.
他不以自己与神同等为强夺的烦恼虚己，取了奴仆的形象。
He did not regard equally with God a thing to be grasped, but emptied himself, taking the form of a bond servant.
保罗也是一样，放弃了他自己的权利。
It's the same case for Paul, who gave up his own right.
哥林多前书九章一节，保罗说：“我不是自由的吗？我不是使徒吗？我不是见过我们的主耶稣吗？你们不是我在主里所做之工吗？”
Paul said this in 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verses 1. Am I not free? Am I not an apostle? Have I not seen Jesus our Lord? Are you not my work in the Lord?
接下来呢，第四到第六节，他接着说：“难道我们没有权柄靠福音吃喝吗？”难道我们没有权柄娶信主的姊妹为妻，带着一同往来，仿佛其余的使徒和主的弟兄，并基法一样吗？独有我与巴拿巴没有权柄不做工吗
？And Paul continues says as following in verses 4-6. Do we not have a right to eat and drink? Do we not have a right to take along the believing wife, even as the rest of the apostles and the brothers of the Lord, and Cephas?Or do only Barnabas and I have no right to refrain from working?
接下来十二节，保罗接着说：“若别人在你们身上有这权柄，何况我们呢？然而我们没有用过这权柄，倒凡事忍受，免得基督的福音被阻隔。”
Then he says this in verses 12: If others share the right over you, do we not more? Nevertheless, we did not use this right, but we endure all things so that we will cause no.Hindrance to the gospel of Christ.
保罗为着福音的缘故和他人的益处呢，他心甘情愿地放下自己的权利。
Paul is willing to give up his own right for the benefits of others in the gospel.
当然，这个是出于心甘情愿。
This is out of his own willingness.
不能像白左一样的强迫别人放弃自己的权利。
Cannot be like the left who force others to give up one's own right.
最后呢，使得你捍卫自己的权利呢，都变成错误了，那就乱套了。
And in the end, if defending one's own rights become a mistake, everything will be in chaos.
拉比们的问题呢，不是在于教导别人捍卫自己应有的权利。
The problem of the rabbi is not to teach people to defend their rightful right.
而是在于他们教导错误的权利。
But they are teaching a wrong right.
以牙还牙的报私仇的权利是神并未赋予的。
It is God does not give the right to fight back for personal revenge.
因为因着人的罪性呢，以牙还牙的报私仇的时候呢，常常会践踏神的公平的原则。
Because due to the sinful nature of human, when we take revenges, one often trample on God's principle of fairness.
别人打掉你一颗牙，你打回来的时候呢，你可能想要打掉他一嘴的牙。
If somebody took one tooth from you, and when you try to give revenge, you may want to take all of his tooth.
所以以恶报恶的结果呢，就是罪恶最后会越来越多。
And because of the human sinful nature, the result of repaying evil with evil is usually more and more evil.
所以当该隐犯罪之后呢，神对该隐说呢，凡杀该隐的必遭报七倍。
That's why after Cain sinned, God said to Cain, "Whoever kills Cain will be punished sevenfold."
有人不理解为什么神还保护凶手该隐呢
？Many doesn't understand why God is protecting the murderer.
因为他们没有足够的信心看到神将来的审判。
That's because those people don't have the confidence, the faith to see God's judgment.
神必定会审判一切的罪人，不会漏掉一个。
God will judge every sinner, no one will be left out.
神这样说的目的呢，是禁止人以恶报恶。
But the reason why God said this to Cain is to prevent people from repaying evil with evil.
后来，该隐的五代孙拉麦，他对他的妻子们夸口说：“壮年人伤我，我把他杀了；少年人损我，我把他害了。”
After that, Lamech, who was the fifth generation grandson of Cain, boasted to his wives, saying that, "For I have killed a man for wounding me, and a boy for striking me."
别人打伤他，他就要把别人杀了。
Somebody wounded him, but he kills the other person as a revenge.
这个呢，就是过分报复的情况。
This is an excessive revenge.
接着他说呢，若杀该隐，遭报七倍；杀拉麦，必遭报七十七倍。
He then said, "If Cain is avenged seven times, then Lamech 77 times."
很显然，这里的第二个报复呢，是从拉麦而来的。
The second revenge here comes from Lamech.
他在夸口呢，他的审判呢，比神的审判更可怕。
He is boasting that his judgment is more terrible than God's judgment.
他在以恶夸口。
He's boasting about evil.
所以拉麦呢，就是和神的教导的这个完全的反面。
Lamech is complete opposite of God's teaching.
很显然呢，罪人的报复呢，常常是过度的。
It's obvious that the revenge of a sinner is often excessive.
而过度的报复呢，是对神的公义的践踏。
An excessive revenge is violation of God's justice.
罗马书十二章的十九节，保罗说：“亲爱的弟兄，不要自己伸冤，宁可让步，听凭主怒，因为经上记着，主说：伸冤在我，我必报应。”
In Romans 12 verses 19, "Never take your own revenge, beloved, but leave room for the wrath of God, for it is written, 'Vengeance is mine; I will repay,' says the Lord."
报仇是神的特权，要相信神的公义。
Vengeance is a privilege of God.As a Christian, we need to believe in His justice.
而犹太拉比们的教导呢，是正好反过来。
The rabbis' teaching are the opposite.
主耶稣反对的不是抵挡罪恶，而是以恶报恶。
The Lord Jesus was opposed is not resisting evil, but repaying evil with evil.
接下来呢，从39到42节，主耶稣连着讲了四种情况。
And from verses 39 to 42, Lord Jesus speak about four different circumstances.
这四种情况是：有人打你，有人告你，有人强迫你，有人求你。
If someone hits you, if somebody files a claim against you, if somebody forces you to do something, or somebody needs to borrow it from you.
这个四种情况呢，讲的其实是同一个道理。
All these four circumstances are really talking about the same principle.
所以，如果你看其中一句觉得无法理解的时候呢，你把四句连起来看，你就清楚了。
So if one circumstance might be difficult to be understood.It will be easier if you look at them all together.
第一种情况呢，有人打你的右脸。
The first circumstance is someone hits your left face.
有一句俗话呢，叫做伤害性不大呢，侮辱性极强。
There's a saying that certain actions not very harmful but very insulting.
打脸呢，就是这样的一种行为。
Hitting someone's face is like that.
它更多的是伤害对方的尊严。
It's more hurting the other's dignity.
而要打一个人的右脸的时候呢，他是需要防守，用手背打，那个、侮辱性更强。
But to hit someone's right face, you need to be using a backward, you need to slap backward, you need to use the back of the hand. It's more insulting.
主耶稣说，打你左脸的，连右脸也给他。
Lord Jesus says, if somebody hits your left face, give him your right face.
这让很多人很困惑。
This confuses a lot of people.
这个是不是有点太造孽了？
Is this just looking for abuse?
但是呢，你看主耶稣被打了之后呢，他并没有这样做。
But you can see that the Lord Jesus himself got beaten up. This is not what he did.
当主耶稣被打的时候，他说：“我若说的不是，你可以指证那不是；我若说的是，你为什么打我呢？”
In John 18:23, when Lord Jesus was beaten, Jesus answered him, "If I have spoken wrongly, testify of the wrong. But if rightly, why do you strike me?"
保罗也是这样。
And the same thing for Paul.
保罗对他说：“你这粉饰的墙，神要打你。你坐堂为的是按律法审问我，你竟违背律法，吩咐人打我吗？”
In Acts 23, verses 3, Paul said to him, "God is going to strike you, you whitewashed wall. Do you sit to try me according to the law, and in violation of the law, order me to be struck?"
主耶稣和保罗呢，他们面对打他的人呢，他不是把右脸给他，而是据理力争。
You can see when Lord Jesus and Paul was facing the person who struck them, they did not just give their right face, but were arguing arguing with them.
他们要为什么而争呢？
What are they arguing for?
他们为程序正义而争。
For procedural justice.
这些居高位掌握权柄的人，他们不按照神的公义办事的时候呢，神的仆人就跟他们相争。
When those who hold a high position and authority do not act in accordance with God's righteousness, God's servants will contend with them.
这样呢，就起到一个监督的作用。
It's a supervisory role.
他们不是委曲求全、逆来顺受。
They're not just giving in and accepting what has happened.
这个就是基督徒参政的榜样。
This is a model for a Christian to participate in politics.
你为什么东西而争？
What are you fighting for?
你应该为神的公义而争。
For God's justice.
因而这些经文的意思呢，如果理解为委曲求全、逆来顺受，就是完全搞错了。
So if it's wrong to comprehend this phrases as it's teaching about giving in, accepting what is happening.
这些经文之所以让人震惊，因为它和我们想要直接打回去的直觉是完全相反的。
The verse is, these phrases are counterintuitive because it's opposite to our instinct that we want to fight back.
因此呢，它直接的表面的意思呢，就是即使在尊严受辱的时候，也不想着报复。
But what it's really teaching is one should not think of revenge even when one's dignity is insulted.
至于更深层次的意思呢，我们后面再说。
And there are some other deeper level meaning as well. We'll talk about that later.
第二种情况呢，是有人要告你。
In the circumstances, somebody wanted to want to sue you.
这个里衣呢，就是贴身的 T-shirt.
Tunic is like your T-shirt.
而外衣呢，就是大衣，长长的。
Cloak or garment is like your coat.
那个时候，普通的人一般只有一件外衣。
At that time, usually a person only owned one coat.
白天当外套呢，晚上还要当毛毯。
Other than wearing them in the day, you also use them as a blanket during the night.
这个出埃及记22:26-27说，你急迫拿邻舍的衣服当做当头，必在日落以前归还他，因他只有这一件当盖头，是他盖身的衣服。若是没有，他拿什么睡觉呢？他哀求我，我就应允，因为我是有恩惠的。
Exodus 22:26-27。If you ever seize your neighbor's cloak as pledge, you are to return it to him before the sun sets, for that is his only covering. It is his cloak for his body. What else is he sleeping in? And if it will come about that when he cries out to me, I will listen to him, for I am gracious.
可见外衣是普通人所不可缺少的生活必需品。
You can see a cloak is necessary for normal people.
因此，如果有人要状告你，想要拿着欧你的外衣的话，这个是财务纠纷。
So if someone wants to sue you and want to take your cloak, this is a financial dispute.
这个是非常不留情面，而且要逼到死地的那种。
And it's a harsh one.
主耶稣说，这样要你外衣的人呢，你连里衣也给他。
Lord's teaching saying, if somebody asks for your coat, give him your tunic.
很显然，能够这样做的人，他的心中是没有苦毒的。
Whoever are able to do that has no bitterness in their heart.
第三种情况，有人强迫你。
The circumstances somebody forced you.
这里呢，我们需要了解一下历史背景。
We need to understand the historical context.
在罗马帝国的时代呢，有一条法律，就是
There's a law in the Roman Empire.
就是罗马士兵在路上行军的时候呢，他可以强迫一个路人来给他搬行李。
That when a Roman soldier was marching on the road, he could force a passerby to carry his luggage.
但是呢，有一个路程限制，就是一里。
But there's a limit on how far it can be, that is 1 mile.
这是一个比较人性化的设计。
This is a kind of a human design.
就是让帝国的公民帮助守卫帝国的士兵呢分担一点重担。
The purpose is to let the citizens of the empire to share some of the burden of the soldier who defend the empire.
作为一个公民呢，尊重和帮助那些保卫国家的人是应该的。
As a citizen, it is right to respect and help those who defend the country.
但是问题是，犹太地是殖民地。
The problem is Judea is a colony.
他们对于这些外来的侵略者是充满仇恨的，更不用说谢谢他们。
The Israeli people are full of hatred towards those invaders, not alone to give them thanks or appreciate them.
所以你可以想象犹太人被罗马士兵抓到要帮他搬行李的时候心里是何等的憋屈和仇恨。
One can imagine how frustrated and hateful when the Jews were caught by the Roman soldier and asked to help carry their luggage.
而主耶稣说你陪他走两里。
The Lord says walk 2 miles with him.
显然这个是在律法的要求以外。
Obviously this is beyond the requirement of the law.
能够陪着走两里的人他的心中是没有憋屈和仇恨。
Because you can walk 2 miles with definitely has no resentment or hatred in one's heart.
这个是他心甘情愿。
One does this out of willingness.
第四种情况是有人求你。
The fourth circumstance is somebody ask you want to borrow from you.
这种情况和前三种不同的地方在于，它不是出于强迫的。
The difference in this circumstance is that it's not you're not forced.
但是和前三种相同的点是，它都会带来损失。
But what's similar about the first three circumstances is that one will always suffer a loss.
帮助别人是需要付出代价。
There is a price to pay for helping others.
有的时候我们不想帮助别人的时候，就会找理由推脱。
Sometimes when we don't want to help others, we find excuses.
但是主耶稣说，求你的就给他。
The Lord Jesus says, if someone wants to borrow from you, just give them.
向你借贷的不可推辞。
Do not turn away from who wants to borrow from you.
我想主耶稣也不是说毫无分辨的让人故意占基督徒的便宜。
I think the Lord Jesus is, also, is not allowing others to take advantage of Christians without any discernment.
他是说别人有真实的需要，你有能力帮助的时候，你不可推辞。
He's saying that when somebody has a true need and you are capable to help, do not find excuse.
因此呢，分辨什么是真正的需要也是要紧。
So it's important to be able to discern what is a true need.
我们教小孩的时候呢，也会帮助他分辨。
This is also something we taught our children.
当他们想要买什么东西的时候呢，我们要帮他分辨到底是出于需要还是出于欲望。
For example, when they want to buy something, we need to help them to discern whether it's out of need or desire.
这个四种情况的分别对应我们个人的尊严、安全、自由和利益。
These four circumstances correspond with personal dignity, safety, freedom, and interest.
这个几乎是一个人做决定的第一考量。
These are almost always the first consideration when the person makes a decision.
一个没有重生的人呢，他做决定的时候呢，基本上一定是从这几点出发的。
Person who hasn't been reborn, they will make a decision based on these four points.
一般情况下呢，你考虑这些东西呢，也不能叫错误。
And usually it's not wrong to take these into consideration.
但是人如果把这些放在神的旨意前面的时候，就有大问题。
But it's going to be a big problem if somebody places these in front of God's will.
就是说一个人他为了要保护自己的尊严、安全、自由、利益而不惜妥协神的公义的时候，最终他想要的他也会失去。
That's to say, when the person is willing to compromise God's justice in order to protect his own dignity, safety, freedom, or interest, he will eventually lose everything.
那么在选举的时候呢，这一点就非常的清楚。
It's quite clear in the election.
我认识很多反对川普的人。
I know a lot of people who are against Trump.
我很奇怪他们怎么对民主党搞的那些倒行逆施的恶行视若不见。
I'm confused about how they are able to turn a blind eye to the evil deeds of the Democratic Party.
原来呢，他们觉得川普很危险。
It turns out that it's because they find Trump to be dangerous.
Not they find, they feel.
They feel Trump is dangerous.
这个呢，就是一叶障目。
This is a very limited point of view.
对川普的仇恨呢，让他们完全忽略了民主党的恶行的危害。
The hatred of to Trump completely blind them to see the evil deeds of the Democratic Party.
我就问他们，川普危险在哪里
？So I asked them exactly where is Trump dangerous?
他们说不出太具体的理由。
There's not a lot of specific reason.
很勉强的理由之一是，川普说了中国病毒容易引起华裔的种族对华裔的种族仇恨。
One of the reasons are Trump talk about China virus and this phrases potentially could cause racial hatred against Chinese people.
理由之二呢是，有人说川普的第一任减税的时候呢，造成他个人的税率增加了。
And second reason is someone said that when Trump cut taxes in his first term, his own tax rate actually increased.
还有一些人是因为川普的对华贸易政策导致他的外贸生意利益受损。
And some just the other some other reasons are Trump's trade policy towards China has caused damage to his own foreign trade business.
而且呢，支持民主党的华人的普遍有一个深深的恐惧，就是害怕华人被抓进集中营。
And Chinese who support the Democratic Party generally have a deep fear that is to be arrested and sent to a concentration camp.
就像二战的时候日本人被关进集中营一样。
Like in the World War II, the Japanese were put into a concentration camp.
他们认为呢，支持民主党的能够保护他们。
They think supporting the Democratic Party can protect them.
于是呢，民主党在招生和就业上牺牲华人利益，他们就忍了。
So when the Democrats sacrificed the interests of the Chinese in enrollment and employment, they tolerated it.
民主党忽悠孩童变性，华人也忍了。
When the Democrats tricked the children into undergoing gender transition surgery, the Chinese tolerated it.
民主党把治安搞得乱七八糟，纽约还有这个加州奥克兰经常有亚裔老人受攻击，华人还是忍了。
And when the Democrats mess up the public security, Asian elderly people are attacked in New York and Oakland, California, Chinese people still tolerate it.
那么我就想问他们忍耐的极限在哪里呢？
Where is the limit of this tolerance?
是不是为了怕进集中营，无论民主党怎么损害华人利益，华人都毅然决然地支持他们呢？
Will Chinese people support them regardless how the Democrats party hurt their interests just for not being put into a concentration camp?
最近呢，这个纽约华人在抗议啊，在华人区中建立游民所，给他们带来安全问题。
Recently, there are Chinese people in New York protesting against the establishment of homeless shelter in the Chinese area.
你说有什么好抗议的？这些民主党政客都是他们自己选出来的。
Those Democrat politicians are elected by them.
他们没有为此而悔改。
They never repent for that.
到了今年十一月，他们还是会选民主党。
And in this year, November, they probably still going to elect for Democrat Party.
在我看来呢，这个有点像斯德哥尔摩综合症。
To me, this is a little like the Stockholm syndrome.
贝德曼呢，还替人数钱，还自认为呢，深谋远虑，忍辱负重。
In advocating for those who cause harm to them and still think that they are far-sighted in their accumulation.
他们为了自己的安全和利益呢，而罔顾神的公义被践踏。
But the point is that they ignore the righteousness of God and trample upon it for the sake of their own safety and interest.
所以他们最终的结果呢，就是既没有公义，也没有安全和利益。
But the final result is that there is neither justice nor safety nor interest for them.
别忘了主耶稣的登山宝训呢，他讲的是天国公民的样子。
Need to remember that the Sermon on the Mount from Lord Jesus is speaking to the pattern of the citizen of the kingdom of heaven.
天国公民和属地的人的区别是泾渭分明的。
The citizen of the heaven is very different from the citizen of the earth.
属地的人考虑问题的第一优先原则就是自己的尊严、安全、自由和利益。
Citizens of earth take personal dignity, safety, freedom, and interest into first consideration. But it's different for the citizens of heaven. What's being taken into first consideration is what's pleasing to God. Not personal interest or personal dislike or likes.
神喜悦的，我们就去做。
We do what is pleasing to God.
哪怕看起来呢，好像对我们个人利益有伤害。
Even when it may seem harmful to our own interests.
这是背起十字架跟从主的真正含义。
This is what it really means to take up the cross and follow the Lord.
乔治穆勒如此说。
George Mueller once said this.
有一天我死了，彻底的向乔治穆勒和他的观点、他的喜好、他的品味、他的意志死了。我向世界。向他的认可和批评死了，我向我的兄弟和朋友们的认可和批评死了。从那时起，我学习单单讨神的喜悦。
There was a day when I died, utterly died to George Mueller and his opinions, his preferences, and his taste and his will. I died to the world, to its approval and its censures. I died to the approval of the or the blame of even my residents and friends.And since then, I have studied only to show myself approved unto God.
这段经文的第一层意义就是舍己。
The first meaning of these phrases are to give up himself.
而这段经文的第二层意义就是主动。
But the second level of meaning is to be proactive.
这个是基督徒的特点。
This is the characteristic of the Christian.
因为我们的神是主动的。
Because our God is proactive.
神是世界的终极的驱动者。
God is the ultimate driver of the world.
就是哲学家口中的第一推动力。
The first mover, as the philosophers call it.
神推动万物而不受万物推动。
God drives everything and is not driven by anything.
基督徒作为神的子民是被神推动。
Christian as a citizen of God is driven by God.
而基督徒向着这个世界是主动的。
And Christians are proactive towards the world.
主耶稣说的那个四种情况中都有超出常人预期的那一部分。
In all four circumstances from Lord Jesus, there are the elements that are expected, normal expectation.
如果说这四种情况的前半段都是被动的话，那么后半段都是主动的。
If the first half of these four circumstances are all passive, then the second half are all proactive.
那么这个意义何在？
What's the meaning?
我举个例子，你就能够明白。
比如说，神吩咐基督徒要爱人如此。God teaches Christians to love others like himself.
这个完全是一个主动的行为。
This is a proactive behavior.
和对方可爱不可爱并无关系。
It's nothing to do whether the other person is lovable.
这个爱的行为呢，完全由神的命令而决定。
And the action of love is completely determined by God's command.
但是如果我们用以牙还牙这种思维模式的话，别人爱你，你来爱他。
However, if you follow the tooth for tooth mentality, you will love someone when they love you.
别人如果恨你，你就恨他。
And you hate them when they hate you.
那这样的话呢，基督徒的生命的样式就不是由神的话语而决定的，而是由世人所决定的。
Such life pattern isn't determined by God's command or word, but are determined by other people, how they treat you.
这样的基督教呢，对世界毫无冲击力。
Such Christianity has no influence to the world.
再比如说呢，有很多基督徒在俄乌战争中支持俄罗斯。
So talk about the second example. A lot of Christians also supported Russia in the Ukraine-Russia war.
从圣经的角度而言，一般情况下，哪里能够得出支持侵略者的结论？
It's very hard to achieve a conclusion, from the biblical perspective to support the invaders.
基督徒美化侵略者是有助纣为虐之嫌，是不荣耀我们神的。
Christians glorifying invaders like this is aiding to the evil and does not glorify our God.
约书亚进迦南地的例子呢，是不足以支持侵略战争的正义性的。
The example of Joshua entering Canaan is not enough to support the justice of the war of aggression.
我们可以说，神所吩咐的侵略战争是有正义性的。
We can say that the war of aggression commanded by God is just.
但是你不能够说所有的侵略战争都是有正义性的。
You cannot say that all war aggression is just.
这些基督徒他们支持俄罗斯的原因呢，是因为俄罗斯是西方世界的敌人。
The reason why these Christians support Russia is because Russia is the enemy of the Western world.
而西方世界呢，现在越来越离经叛道。
We know that the Western world is becoming more and more unorthodox.
因而他们根据敌人的敌人是朋友的原则呢，把普京美化成。保守主义和基督信仰的护卫者。
So based on the principle that the enemy is a friend, they portray Putin as a defender or of conservatism and Christianity.
这个就扯远了。
And this is ridiculous.
普京只是想要打下一个大大的疆土，没有那么多复杂的心思。
Putin just wants to expand Russia's territory. There isn't really any other drivers behind that.
那按照这个逻辑，坚定反美的金将军岂不也成了保守主义的斗士吗
？And based on the same principle, Kim Jong-un, who is also sitting on the opposite side of the Western world, would also be a warrior that is fighting for conservatism.
这不是很可笑吗
？It's obviously ridiculous.
那么这些所谓的保守主义者，怎么没有见他搬到俄罗斯或者朝鲜去呢
？Why these so-called conservatism doesn't move to Russia or North Korea？
说明他们的脚还是明白的，他们只是脑子拎不清。
It's because their body can't understand; it's just their brain are confused.
这些人的错误观念的背后的原因呢，就是违背了主动性的原则。
The reason behind this people's ridiculous idea is that it violates the principle of initiative.
他们的立场不是由圣经决定的，而是由他们敌人的立场决定。
Their position is not determined by the Bible, but by the opposition.By the position of their enemy.
但是主耶稣说的这个四种情况都是基督徒在为义受苦中显示出来的主动性。
But all four examples in Lord Jesus' teachings are all examples of Christian showing initiative in suffering for righteousness.
当世人为此而惊奇的时候呢，他们会思想。
And when people are shocked by this, they will think.
为什么这个人受了羞辱，他毫不退缩呢？
Why the person does not retreat when humiliated?
为什么这个人连礼仪都失去，他也不愿亏欠别人呢？
Why the person is even to even giving up his tunic?
为什么这个人已经尽到公民的义务了，他还要额外的多走一里呢？
Why this person has clearly fulfilled the responsibility of a citizen but still want to walk the extra mile?
为什么这个人愿意尽他所能的来帮助别人？
Why this person is willing to help others with all his capability?
为什么他那么的不一样？
Why are they so different?
他的勇敢，他的热情是从哪里来的？
Where is their braveness, their kind heart and passion come from?
因为在他的背后有一位主动的神在推动着他。
That's because behind them there is a proactive God pushing them.
那么接下来我们讲这段经文的第三层意义。
And then we want to talk about the third layer of meaning of this this passage.
这段经文的第三层意义是天国的子民呢是不可撼动的。
The citizen of the kingdom of heaven is unshakable.
史书上记载呢，抗金名将岳飞的敌人啊，对他的军队的评价是汉三义，汉岳家军呢。
The enemies of Yue Fei, the famous general who fought against the Jin dynasty, commented on by his army that his enemy that it is easy to shake a mountain, but it's difficult to shake Yue Fei's army.
意思是岳家军比山都难以撼动。
Means the armies of Yue Fei is even harder to shake compared to the mountain.
从敌人那里得到这样的评价是非常高的。
It's a very high praise coming from his enemy.
基督徒呢，应该要比岳家军更加难以撼动。
The Christians should be even harder to shake compared to Yue Fei's army.
因为我们的元帅呢，远比岳飞伟大。
Because our general is far more greater than Yue Fei.
因为我们的方向，我们的动力都是从神而来的。
Our direction and initiatives all come from God.
而不是从世界来的，这个就是不可撼动的原因。因为人把什么东西放在自己心中的第一位，他就容易被那个东西驱动。
People are most likely to be driven by what they put first in their hearts.
当然，我们都知道呢，神应该在人的心中居首位。
We know God should be in the first place.
除了神以外的任何东西在人心中居首位的，他就有一个名字叫做什么？
Other than God, whoever is put into the first place in people's heart, what do we call them?
偶像
Idol.
因而别人可以通过操控一个人心中的偶像来操控他。
Other can manipulate a person through manipulating the idol.
而唯一的别人无法控制的就是真神。
The only thing that cannot be manipulated is the true God.
真神是主动的神。
And the true God is proactive.
换句话说呢，拜偶像呢，就是走向奴役之路。
In the other word, idol worshiping is a way to slavery.
敬拜真神就是自由之路。
And the worshiping of the true God is a way to freedom.
在选举中呢，我们很容易看到这样的操控。
We often see this kind of manipulation in election.
政客呢，很会抓住人性的弱点。
Politicians are great at grasping people's weakness.
看重利益的就用利益吸引他。
Those who emphasize on interest, they will attract him with interest.
比如说吃福利的。
For example, those who depends on social welfare.
看重表面功夫的就说漂亮话吸引他。
Those who value superficial work, politicians will use nice words to deceive them.
比如说虚伪的白左。
Such as the hypocritical left.
玻璃心的人就挑拨离间去搅动他。
Those are fragile snowflakes. The politicians will cause dispute among them.
比如说，因为川普说过 China virus 而反对他的人，就在这样的人面前多提 China virus.
For example, when certain people oppose Trump because he once said China virus, then the politicians will often mention the phrase China virus in front of them.
放纵的人呢，就鼓励他放纵。
The indulgent person will be encouraged to continue to live the lifestyle.
比如说支持堕胎、支持 LGBTQ 的人。
For example, those who support abortion and LGBTQ.
胆小的人就吓唬他。
The coward people, then the politicians will try to scare them.
比如说害怕进集中营的人，你就告诉他共和党上台了，华人有进集中营的危险。
Or those who are afraid to put into a concentration camp, politicians will try to convince them that when the republic is taking place, Chinese might be put into a concentration camp.
比如说害怕枪击案的人呢，就鼓吹控枪，引导他反共和党。
And those who are afraid of gunshot incidents, the politicians will vote about the gun controls to drive him against the Republic.
也不知道那些人为什么那么傻，那么好骗，他们哪里来的莫名其妙的对民主党的信心
？Not really sure why those people are so easy to fool and where their confidence to the Democratic Party come from.
要知道，我们二战的时候呢，把日本人送进集中营的，正是民主党。
You do know that during the Second World War, World War II, it's the Democrats Party that put the Japanese into concentration camp.
民主党管理的地区的枪击案是最多的，如芝加哥吧地方。
And the Democrats govern the area usually have the most amount of gunshot cases, like Chicago or Baltimore.
民主党的票仓呢，基本上就是这个几类人，都是靠人性的软弱而操控的。
And the Democrats Party's voting base basically consists of all these types of people.All of whom are manipulated by taking advantage of their weakness.
我混在一些左派的群里面呢，里面的这些民主党选民对充满对川普的仇恨。
I was in a lot of group among the left, and they are filled with people who has large amount of hatred towards Trump.
经常呢，他们很容易就为川普说的一些话冒犯到。
They are easily offended by Trump's word.
事实上呢，冒犯到他们的常常不是川普的视频或者音频，而是某些左媒的断章取义的转述。
Often what's offended them is not Trump's video or audio, but rather some left-wing media's quotation of Trump's word out of context.
我感觉到有一种阴谋。
I feel like there's something being planned.
就是民主党呢刻意引导。或者说筛选他们的选民处于一种特别情绪化的状态。
That's the Democrats Party wanted to have and wanted to drive or lead their voter, their base to be in a always emotional situation.
就是很玻璃心的，一会儿被这句话冒犯，一会儿被那句话冒犯。
In such situations, they are easily offended.
这样的话呢，他们的注意力完全在川普的怎么可恨呢？
This way, they will completely focus on how hateful Trump is.
他们看不到大局。
And unable to see the bigger picture.
他们不会理性的思考政策的利弊对我。
And will unable to rationally think about the pros and cons of the policies.
哈里斯在政坛那么多年，基本上没有做过什么好的事情。
Harris has been in the politicians for years and haven't really done anything good.
民主党也不宣传这一点。
But the Democrats Party wouldn't advocate for those.
他们挑动选民热情的唯一点就是对川普的仇恨，现在又加上对旺斯的仇恨。
The only thing that they have to stir up voters' enthusiasm is hatred for Trump and now hatred for Vance.
但是呢，作为选民，仅靠个人的好恶来对待国家未来的选择是非常轻率。
It is extremely rash and irresponsible to make choices about the country's future based solely on personal lives.
为什么这些人看不到他们的现实的利益被损害呢？
Why does this person doesn't see their actual interests being harmed?
为什么他们仍然心甘情愿选择那些祸害他们的？
Why are they so willingly electing for those who harm them?
因为他们心中有更看重的东西，就是他们的偶像被拿捏住了。
Because they have something more important in their heart, their idol is being manipulated.
他们深深地相信川普上台会毁掉他们的生活。
They deeply believe that when Trump takes power, their life will be ruined.
而不考虑呢这个逻辑是否合理。
And they don't try to think whether this is a logical conclusion.
我们说这些东西做什么？
Why do we want to talk about this?
这些和我们的信仰有什么关联？
Are they related to our faith?
因为这种利用人性的软弱而进行心理操控的轨迹，正是出于那恶的。
Because this kind of psychological manipulation scheme that take advantages of human weakness come from the evil one.
所以，一个基督徒他若是看见神喜悦什么，他就不容易被威逼利诱来操控。
If a Christian see what's pleasing to God, then he will not be easily manipulated.
他不会因为听到各种各样的声音而犯糊涂。
It will not just float around with all sort of voices and opinions. He will be like a ship with anchor. Because he knows what is pleasing to God. And he knows what God hates. He has a very clear path.
他也可以轻松地识别那些借着偶像来捆绑人的轨迹。
And he can easily see through the schemes of those who bind people with through idols.
愿我们都是这样的基督徒。
May we be Christians like this.
最后我们总结一下。
And let's summarize today's message.
天国子民的驱动力，它不是自己的尊严、安全、自由、利益，而是神的旨意。
What drives the people of the citizens of the heavens is not their own dignity, safety, freedom, or interest, but God's will.
第二点，天国子民对于这个世界是主动的，而不是被动的。
The citizen of the heaven is proactive to the world; it's not passive.
第三点，天国的子民是不可撼动的。
And the third point is the citizen of heaven is unshakable.
好，我们一同来祷告。
Let's pray together.
主啊，我们感谢赞美你。
Lord, we thank you and praise you.
主啊，我们今天讲的这一段经文是很多被误解的。
We are talking about one of the most misunderstood phrases.
主啊，但是孩子相信今天已经解释的足够的清楚。
I think this is clearly explained.
主啊，保守你的子民能够将这样的话牢牢地藏在心中。
And please.Help your people so we can keep your word firmly in our heart.
当我们做决定的时候，帮助我们不要做一个自私的人。
And when we make decisions, help us to not be a selfish person.
不是只想着自己的利益得失。
Not just be thinking about our own interest.
而是想着主你的旨意是什么。
But God's will.
主啊，你必定将你的路显明给我们。
God, you will show your path for us.
带领我们走这永生的道路。
Please lead us on the path to eternal life.
与我们同在。
And be with us.
我们的感谢和祷告都是奉我主耶稣基督的圣名。
Thanks and prayer in the name of Jesus Christ.